represented in this, demonstration. This demonstration is taking place, as you know, all over the world, March for Science. And in our country, it is taking place in at least 150 different locations. It already has taken place in Assam on the 11th of April, because in Assam it is today, and therefore they held it a couple of days earlier. We know that today is also Ambedkar Jayanti in Maharashtra, and there are many programs, and many people who would be here today are actually part of the programs for Ambedkar Jayanti. And in fact, it is very fitting that we hold our march along with the other programs on Ambedkar Jayanti, because there is a lot in common between what Dr. Ambedkar stood for. He was the architect, the chairman of the drafting committee of our constitution, and perhaps our constitution is one of the few, or maybe even the only constitution in the world, where scientific temper is explicitly mentioned in the constitution, in Article 51A. Article 51A mentions the duties of every Indian citizen, and 51AH says specifically that it is the duty of every Indian citizen to promote scientific temper, humanism, and reform. So what we are doing today is taking forward the traditions of our national movement, because the constitution came out of the national movement. The leaders of the national movement also put forward the concept of scientific temper. The word scientific temper was perhaps first put forward very clearly in the writings of Jawaharlal Nehru, who was our first prime minister. And so what we are doing today has a broader significance. Now, why we are doing it today, why it is necessary today, I will not talk about that, because other speakers will talk about that. But as you know, there are many things happening in our country which requires us to take a stand defending science and for promoting science. But I will leave that for the other speakers to talk about. I would only like to end by saying, and by informing everybody here today, that last month in the Bhubaneswar, there was the All India People's Science Congress, which was attended by a large number of organizations covering most of the states of India. These were scientists, these were organizations working for promoting science, known as the All India People's Science Network. Now, at that conference, on the 12th of March, it was proposed and unanimously adopted to observe a day of a national day of scientific temper all over the country. As you know, we have the National Day of Mathematics on the 22nd of December, which is the day of Ramanujan. We have the National Day of Science, which is the 28th of February, which is associated with the work of Dr. C.V. Raman. So now it has been proposed and unanimously adopted that we will observe National Day of Scientific Temper. And that day has been chosen as August 20th, which is the day on which Dr. Narendra Dabholkar was martyred. Dr. Narendra Dabholkar himself has given wonderful lectures on scientific temper. Of course, they are in Marathi, but they have been translated into other languages. And on this August 20th, the day of national scientific temper will be observed all over India. So I welcome everybody here today, along with our colleagues in Pune, in Goa, in Bangalore, so many other cities. We will shortly take out our march. In the coming days, it is very important that all of us work together to promote scientific temper. Why that is necessary and what we have to do, I will leave the other speakers to speak. Thank you for giving me this opportunity.
One thing, people who are standing, can you just come here and sit down, please? We are anyway having a